The voice preprocessing TI design for the K2G platform features a demo. In this video, we will take a look at how to run this demo on the K2G EVM. The voice preprocessing TI design demo on the K2G EVM is set up as illustrated here. The audio inputs are taken into the K2G EVM through a 8-mic circular mic board or CMB using the I2S protocol. The audio is then processed using various algorithms such as beamforming, adaptive spectral noise reduction, multi-source selection, and dynamic range control. These algorithms are referred by the acronyms BF, ASNR, MSS, and DRC respectively. The output of the DRC, which contains a signal with the highest energy, is sent through the headphone jack on the EVM to listen to the audio. Clean audio, which has gone through processing, can be heard on the left ear. Unclean raw audio from the center reference microphone is fed into the right headphone ear. This provides a great way to distinguish the impact of voice preprocessing on the audio signal. The best way to analyze the audio is to connect the headphone output to a PC. Software such as Adobe Audition or Audacity can now be used to better analyze the audio quality. The circular mic board or CMB is an 8-mic circular array with 7 mics on the periphery and 1 center reference mic. It is designed with Knowles analog mics. Digital mics can also be used in a design if desired. The mics feed into 2 PCM1864 ADCs on the underside of the array, which output audio using the I2S protocol. These I2S lines can be interfaced to the DSP as seen fit. We also have a .stl 3D printer file so that anyone can 3D print a small standoff for the CMB PCB. This provides a nice stable platform for the CMB to sit on when running the audio preprocessing demo. Here are the connection details between the K2G EVM and the circular mic board or CMB. Please pay close attention to the jumper settings underneath the CMB. It is a tight fit to squeeze in the cable, so please pay close attention to ensure the wires aren't crossed. Let's now look into the software packages that contain the audio preprocessing demos. The K2G Process SDK RTOS package has the K2G audio preprocessing demo starting with version 3.03. These demos can be found at the path specified here. Note that there are various dependent components that are part of the AER and VoiceLib packages, which would need to be included in the build. In this segment, we will take a closer look at the K2G real-time audio preprocessing demo. We will assume that the K2G Processor SDK RTOS package and CCS version 6.1.3 are installed at C:TI. Also ensure the AER and VoiceLib packages are installed at the correct locations. Navigate to the Processor SDK RTOS package as seen here and run the setenv.bat file. This will set up the build tools environment. Next, navigate to the build directory of the real-time demo. Do a gmake clean, followed by a gmake all. At this point, the demo build process will begin. Please note that this build can take several minutes, so let's cut to the chase for the sake of time. Once the build completes, the K2G beamforming real-time binary will be populated in the build directory as seen here. This binary can now be run on the C66X core on the K2G EVM. Assuming that the CMB is connected, let's see how you would load and run the demo. We will not cover CCS setup content in this segment. However, please see the Getting Started with CCS link at the end of this video for more information. In CCS, launch a target configuration for the K2G EVM. Connect to the C66X core, ensuring that the gel file is loaded on the core. Navigate to the location of the K2G BFRT.out binary we built previously and load it on the core. CCS symbols will also get loaded, which will allow for setting breakpoints in the code to further examine the behavior of the demo. Hit resume, and at this point, the demo will start running. In this case, we have the line out from the EVM connected to the PC line in. We will launch Audacity and see the audio output from the demo. Here we can see the left channel with the clean audio and the right side with unclean audio. This can be recorded and split into left and right channels in order to listen to each channel separately. This provides a great way to analyze the processed and unprocessed audio quality. This completes the segment which covered the basics of beamforming, design tools, hardware and software used to demonstrate the real-time audio preprocessing on the K2G platforms. If you have any questions on running these demos, please use TI's E2E forums for assistance. Thank you for watching.